Your Holiness, welcome to the program. Good to see you again. Let me ask you about your life's work, which is to try to get more autonomy, real autonomy for Tibet.
Yes.
You're turning 80. You've turned 80. Oh. Will you ever see that in your lifetime? Have you succeeded?
I think so. Today's China, compared 20, 30 years ago, it's much changed. It's still changing. Then the human desire, freedom, yes, you see, everywhere.
You say China's changed a lot. Of course it has, particularly economically. They are still very tightly controlled politically. And they talk badly about you in the press. They call you divisive, frivolous, disrespectful. They think you're still a splittist. That is what they call you. Are you?
No. Since 1974, we decided we are not seeking independence.
Since 1974?
Yes. Everybody knows we are not seeking independence. But Chinese people also, you see, Chinese people or many Chinese intellectuals or Buddhists, they know. But, you see, government, you see, they stand, or Dalai Lama splitist, that kind of stand is fit their hardliner policy.
So there's a big struggle between you and the Chinese authorities over succession. You picked the Panchen Lama, who, as we all know, was kidnapped, you know, when he was 6 years old, 20 years ago. The Chinese have recently said that he is growing up healthily and does not want to be disturbed. Who's going to be the next Tibetan leader, spiritual leader?
So Dalai Lama case, you see, as early as 69, I publicly, formally, officially, I announced the very institution of Dalai Lama should continue or not up to Tibetan people.
So do you think...
I have no concern.
You're the 14th Dalai Lama.
The Chinese government, you see, more concerned about Dalai Lama institution than me.
Do you think that the institution will continue after you, or might you be the last Dalai Lama?
Possible, last Dalai Lama. I personally feel better. The people should take full responsibility, like sort of political responsibility. At least last four centuries, Dalai Lama automatically become head of both temporal and spirituality. Now, 2011, I totally retired from political responsibility. Not only myself retired, but also four century old tradition. Dalai Lama institution automatically become head of both the spiritual and temporal. That formally, voluntarily, happily ended. Now, the Chinese eye, Dalai Lama still is politically something important. So actually not now.